I like to think of design as constant, uncertain decision making. You probably already noticed that I use design and innovation pretty simultaneously. We're always thinking about what is desirable to whom. There are these constant unknowns and interdependencies of our work. There are disengagement risks within your organization before you even get a product to market. And there are product failure risks that are well known. I like to think of these projects as really a group of decisions, thousands of decisions that are all prone to bias. And we tend to measure success or failure on the outcome, but we can do a lot in changing the decisions that lead to the outcome. Frameworks like design thinking can help us reduce the bias of those decisions and to question if we're still solving the right problem and whether our assumptions of the persona that we're solving for still hold true. So this example was a project that I was on. This was for Kering, and Kering is a competitor to LVMH. They own the Gucci group and many luxury brands. So this project began with the question of how might we help consumers to make sustainability the new luxury by the year 2025. And what we would have done is on the top here. So we started with that question about making consumers change their behavior. And we would have then gone on to build, you know, shirts made out of bamboo and many, many kind of obvious ideas. What we ended up doing was starting a design thinking process with consumers. And what we realized in that process is that consumers were buying sort of whatever the designers were making. And that ended up being our fundamental insight, where we realized that our designers aren't making the decisions to provide the consumers with the opportunity to even begin this behavior change. And so we started a new design thinking process with our designers, specifically to understand the environment in which they make decisions about material choices. That led to a solution that we would have never ended up coming to otherwise. And that was to develop a sustainable materials lab that all of the companies, Gucci, Stella McCartney, Alexander McQueen, et cetera, they're all owned by this holding company, could access. And we also invented the first ever environmental profit and loss statement, which enabled tracking and measuring progress towards sustainability. Because the reason this wasn't working before is because designers in this company don't have time to research materials or to track the sustainability metrics of their suppliers. So we went in an entirely different direction, and we're still bearing the fruits of those innovations.